Like all scientists, Isaac Newton made observations about the world around him. Some of his observations were about motion. His observations have been supported by more data over time, and we now call these Newton's laws of motion. His laws of motion explain rest, constant motion, accelerated motion, and describe how balanced and unbalanced forces act to cause this state of motion. These laws apply to objects in the real world and have allowed us to do things like launch satellites in space, race cars, and play carom really well. Whether we are aware of them or not, Newton's laws of motion are at play in nearly every physical action of our daily lives. The first law defines the force qualitatively, the second offers a quantitative measure of the force, and the third asserts that a single isolated force doesn't exist. Football is at rest. It will not move unless acted upon by external force like player's leg. This football will go forever in the absence of external forces like friction. Mihir is traveling in a car and driver suddenly applies brake. He is thrown forward suddenly. When car is moving, Mihir is also moving. When brakes are applied, car comes to halt, but Mihir is thrown forward due to inertia of motion. Handle in the moving trains swing backwards when train starts and forward when train halts. A car continues in straight line until we change the direction using external force on its steering. Certain bodies such as butterflies pose little resistance and are moved with ease. Others such as ships resist more and are moved with more difficulty. This resistance of motion, more precisely, to change of motion is called inertia. An object initially at rest is predicted to remain at rest if the total force acting on it is zero, and an object in motion remains in the motion with the same velocity in the same direction. This is Newton's first law of motion. You must have played a tug of war. As long as two sides apply equal force, center of the rope remains at one location. When applied forces are unequal, the side with more force wins. What happens if the total force on an object is not zero? It accelerates. Numerical prediction of the resulting acceleration is the topic of Newton's second law. Season ball will take more force to throw than the tennis ball, as its mass is more than that of a tennis ball. If you catch the ball without moving the hand, it might hurt you. If you catch the ball while moving your hand along its path, it won't hurt. Tennis ball is hit by the racket. More you hit, faster it goes. More the force, greater the momentum. Cricket ball is much more heavy than a tennis ball. Suppose we throw a cricket ball and a tennis ball, both with the same speed or velocity, it will be found that more force is required to stop the cricket ball, which has more mass, and less force is required to stop the tennis ball, which has less mass. Therefore, we can say that the force required to stop a moving body is directly proportional to its mass. Momentum is the resistance to stopping. It is kind of inertia for moving bodies. Momentum can be defined as mass in motion. All objects have mass, so if an object is moving, then it has momentum. It has its mass in motion. The amount of momentum that an object has is dependent upon two variables: how much stuff is moving and how fast the stuff is moving. Momentum depends upon the variable masses and velocity. In terms of an equation, the momentum of an object is equal to the mass of the object times the velocity of the object. Momentum is equal to mass times velocity. In physics, the symbol for the quantity momentum is lowercase p. P is equal to m multiplied by v, where m is the mass and v is the velocity. The equation illustrates that momentum is directly proportional to an object's mass and directly proportional to the object's velocity. The units for momentum would be mass units times velocity units. The standard metric unit of momentum is kilogram meter per second. When we throw two cricket balls of the same mass but with different speed or velocities, then it will be found that more force is required to stop that cricket ball which is moving with higher speed or velocity than other with lower speed or velocity. So we can say that the force required to stop a moving body is also directly proportional to its velocity. Thus, the quantity of motion in a body depends on the mass and velocity of the body. Momentum is a vector quantity and takes place in the direction of velocity. A karate player breaks a pile of tiles or a slab of ice with a single blow of his hand. This is because a karate player strikes the pile of tiles with his hand very, very fast. In doing so, the large momentum of the fast moving hand is reduced to zero in very, very short time. This exerts a very large force on the pile of tiles, which is sufficient to break them apart. A bullet, although small in mass, has a large momentum because of an extremely large velocity. A swimmer pushes backward against the water. The water pushes forward on him. An athlete can jump higher off a solid surface because it opposes his body with as much force as he is able to generate, in contrast to sand or other unstable surface. Lock the two balances in each other and pull each one. Regardless of who tries to pull harder, the two forces as measured on the spring scales are equal. Inflate a balloon and fix it on the hole in the boat. Release the boat in water. What happens to the boat as the air in the balloon escapes slowly? Why? Newton, after observing a series of results such as these, decided that there must be a fundamental law of nature at work. Forces occur in equal and opposite pairs. Whenever object A exerts a force on object B must also be exerting a force on object A. The two forces are equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. This is Newton's third law. We can use plus and minus signs to indicate the direction of forces, and Newton's third law can be written as FA on B is equal to minus FB on A. Newton's third law always involved two objects and referred to pair of opposite forces of same type. We discussed laws of motion with help of everyday examples. Do find more such examples from your everyday activities for each law. Take this challenge. What will happen in this situation? Will the car move when weight is released?